Good day, everyone. My name is Sifu Cicero in the School of Qi Energy, and today we're going to talk about the school's first year of training, going from Yang to Yin. And to talk about this today is the headmaster of the school, Sifu Jones. Sifu Jones, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well. Today's topic is on the school's first year of training and going from Yang to Yin, because the vast majority of people that will come in to the school are really on the Yang side as compared to a Yin side, a more relaxed side. And the first year of training is all about teaching the student how to get their body to relax, how they're going to learn to do these lying down meditations that will really change the way the stresses of life seem to throw at us in today's world. You get hit with stress on all sides, and it's through going through this type of a program that will really get you your joy back from life. That's all about what we're doing here in the school. It's teaching a person to tune in to the right kind of energy in the first place, and by doing so, they can learn a whole set of new types of techniques that they probably didn't even think were possible, but they're certainly possible, and our students learn them all the time and every day. What we do is get them to start out in the right way doing this nerve fiber building exercise. What it does is starts moving the energy around your body if it has stagnated in any one area in the body. By doing this particular exercise, it really gets all of the circulation back into really good flow. And the movement of the nerve fibers themselves, it starts getting them used to extra energy going through them. That is probably the biggest and hardest thing for most students to understand, that they can only build up in their own body a certain amount in any one day or any one week for that matter, and to do so only leads to overloading their own body and to bad side effects. We really try to avoid all the bad side effects that you can get from energy work and really try to get them to hone it down so that the only side effects they get would be really good ones and pleasant ones. When you do this type of a method right, you really do get the most pleasant types of side effects. I came from the martial art background. It was all about breaking bricks and breaking board, getting more and more power out of your body. So I can totally understand that some of our students come in and that's what they're about. They just want, okay, show me the power of the chi. They kind of think of this thing as a Superman thing. They don't really see it for what it really is. It's more of an electrical process. It's using biophotons, and that's what your body naturally puts out as chi, or this chi energy is really made up of biophotons. Biophotons act just like electricity does in a lot of respects. As you clump it together, they totally act like electricity acts that would be in your wall. So it comes out very hot and destructive. And what we try to teach people to do is how to cool these biophotons that we do put out down. Because if you can cool them down, you can do so many more things and accomplish so many more things with them. Most people kind of come in with this mentality that they just want the power now. They don't really want to tune into the precision of what the method is, whereas if you can learn this precision that goes along with the method, you can get really good with this stuff. One of the first things that you learn to do is to cool the energy down, to also make the energy feel good, or our tri-concept. And it really does matter whether you do this tri-concept or not, doesn't it?
The tri-concept, it sounds complicated, but it's really not. And in fact, we invite our students during month one to have a free session with us. They'll tangibly feel right over the phone how that coolness can come right into the palm of their hands and start to cool the nerve fibers down.
A lot of people, when you say tri-concept, it's kind of hard for them to understand what that is. And what we're really saying there, it's kind of you multitasking. What we mean by multitasking is not only do you have to pay attention to this form of energy that you're going to be able to project, but you have to make that energy feel good and you have to make it feel cool. So the first part of the concept is the form itself. The second is making it cool. And the third is making a good feeling. And you put that together as a tri-concept. And we use that so that you're going to start learning to put the right kind of energy out that does make your body feel good when you're putting good feeling energy into the mix and not just, well, most people don't even care or think about what the energy is going to feel like as they build up energy. They just want to cultivate as much as they can. That's the problem. If you cultivate a lot of energy or you have a system that does cultivate a lot of energy, it really can backfire on you very quickly as that energy gets really hot and destructive. You just want to get it out of your body because it's just causing you all sorts of problems. Both you and I went through systems that's how you did do the energy. You made it as hot as possible, and you packed it in as good as you could and hope for the best. Usually what would happen is it starts driving you crazy, and so you'd have to release it. Now, in my case, I was a martial artist, and so I would literally release that energy to break bricks and boards, and I could break bigger and bigger boards as I learned to cultivate more and more energy. But it was such a roller coaster ride on me. One moment, you'd just be in the low lows, and the next, you're in the high highs. And when you were able to accomplish, like break a big brick or something, you felt good, but it wasn't long before the other side of the coin played, and you were really feeling bad again, and it was such a hormonal up and down type of feeling. So I realized that this was not good on me, because during those type of times, you get in a lot of arguments and a lot of fights with people, and it's totally not necessary. It really has to do with how your energy feels. So the first year is all about getting the student to think about what that is, what kind of energy that they really do want to put out. This good feeling stuff is the best way to do it and to build it up so that you want to continue to build it up because it does feel good in the first place. We show people exactly how to do that in the school. And also how to lower the temperature of your body in the school, because that's the other thing that most people think, well, you can't lower your inner temperature. I mean, how would you do that? There is this whole process that we take them through, and it takes about 30 days to get it down where you can literally, on demand, lower your own temperature. These are some of the type of chi techniques you learn in the school in that first year that are really important to learn. Because if you don't care about how hot the energy gets, it will put it into such a room that you can cause damage to your body. Because the exercises that are coming past the first year go way up in power. When I first started doing this way back when, I would try to teach different ways of teaching this particular method. And I would try to do some of the more stronger energy exercises first, because nobody wants to waste any time. So I would try to teach those to different people, and I never could get anybody that would really stay in. They would usually just hurt themselves, overload their body over and over and over again until it really wasn't a very fun thing. I realized that doing it in the way that now we have it set up, the whole school, is that you allow your body to adapt to more and more energy, to just throw a lot of energy at it right at the get-go. Just overloads it way too much, and you just go through a really rough roller coaster ride again. The other things that we did realize is that the exercises were stronger than the other type of exercises out there. We both went through the different types of qigongs and energy methods. We were used to using breaths in different ways and using sounds, the six healing heart sounds and all that kind of stuff with anything that we did, standing postures. I certainly did the hour a day on standing postures for years. This is something I was trying to do with this method at first, too, when I first really started figuring out how you're building up the size of the nerve fibers of the body. So I incorporated all that. You learn that kind of stuff, and you think, well, we might as well add it in. But all that would do was just lead to overload of the body, too. So we realized real quick that the only way you're going to be able to do this in a way that you can just consistently build more and more energy up, you had to do it in a very precise way. Our first year is all about teaching the student that precision, the being able to put out energy in this good feeling and cool way, where it's actually cool feeling energy. If you were projecting energy at a person, they would physically feel it as a cool type of pressure and density coming at them, and it would literally have a good feeling to it. Because that's the thing about biophotons. These biophotons can hold up to 4 megabytes of your thought information. So if you're putting good feeling information in it and good feeling emotion into it, these biophotons can actually carry that and put off that type of emotion to anybody around you. And it's really easy to feel. The cool thing about this, since it acts just like electricity does, it works just right over the phone even. we can, with the students that we deal with, regularly talk with them and deal with them in this way where they can feel us right over the phone and we can get right through to them, show them how to feel it this way or that way. It's so much easier to tune into a person that way. And haven't you found that it works so much better of teaching students when you do it that way?
Excellent way to teach students, because if their pressure and density is a little bit too hot or a little bit too formy, it's so easy to teach them, oh, just make it a little bit more good feeling, a little bit more cooler. And they do it right away, and they're like, oh, that's how it's supposed to feel. Exactly. That's how easy it is.
Most people don't realize this, but we actually provide 3 free sessions with instructors so that they can get this training down and be the best that they can at it. The students that really take us up on taking 3 different sessions, and usually you take the first one after that first month so that you can make sure that you're tuning into everything right, and if you haven't got something up and working, then we help you get it up and working so that you literally can put out this cool chi rather than hot chi. Really easy to put out hot chi. It's what comes out pretty hot unnaturally. And so it's really easy, since it's already hot, to make it a lot hotter. But the problem with making it a lot hotter is it causes all sorts of problems to your own body. We have found and done the science on it, and you do things like burn your pheromones, or you like slow down your natural killer cells' abilities simply by having too much heat in your body, and you also cause inflammatory type of hormones to stay into your body much longer when you're too hot than if you can learn to cool your own body down. It's so nice to be able to go out on a hot day and you don't even have to sweat because you learned how to cool your own self down. That kind of sounds funny that you have that ability to do that, but this is literally what we're talking about, is changing the inside temperature of your body, making it much cooler. Now, the typical person has a 98.6, that's considered normal by doctors, is the temperature in your head. Well, if you did this method and you did it for very long with the amount of chi cultivation you're building up, your head would be way, way too hot, and it would consistently stay over 100 degrees hot by building up a whole lot of energy. So we help students learn to cool down different parts of their body so that where their head was at 98.6 to begin with, maybe, we've taken it down to more like the 88 to 92 in that first year, so that as they build up more and more energy, they're not getting affected adversely, because that really is usually where you're going to get affected the most, is having the energy too hot up in your head. Of course, everybody knows as heat rises, and that's the first place it'll go from your body. If your body's too hot in different places, pretty soon that energy is going to go right up into your head and heat up your head. We teach students how that whole process is how you cool down, how that kind of thing would happen. We do everything in a moderation way. We have found that moderation is the key to the best way of just consistently going up to the mountaintop, instead of just spinning your wheels and going around the mountain the whole bunch, but not really going too much higher. We're all about getting you to a higher level when you go through a school like this. It's all about getting that first bit down, and that really does cause for sensitivity. When we started doing this, we thought, well, the easiest way to teach somebody how to stay on the sensitive side is to teach them these 2 to 5 minute sensitivity training exercises where they have to be on this yin side or in a relaxed mode in order to be performing the chi technique. And it's things like filling through a closed container or moving a drinking straw in a closed container where you're taking out all of the like wind or anything like that, condensation or anything that would unduly influence a straw to make it move in the first place. We show them specifically how to do those kind of things, how to tune in to collars. Like if you were blindfolded, how would you tune into that collar so that you could feel the difference between one or the other? Well, these are sensitivity type things that you have to be relaxed in order to do them. If you're not relaxed, you can't even come close to doing them well. You usually can tell really quickly of how you did your workout or how you did your energy workout that we have you go through each day as feedback. You do one of those after you finish, and you can kind of tell how well you were doing in your workout, how you kept it on the good feeling and cool side by how well you'll be able to do your 2 to 5 minute exercise. When you are too far off on your 2 to 5 minute exercise, then a lot of times that shows you that, well, maybe I got to take off for a day or two, get my energy back down where I can get control over it, then start from there again. A lot of times that is the best way that you're going to see a lot of gains in this type of energy work. But if people would concentrate on that part, or that first part where you actually learn how to cool down your energy in the first place and to make your energy feel good, when they learn these much, much stronger energy exercises in the second, third, and fourth year, because by the fourth year, it's the difference between doing a nerve fiber building exercise and learning how circuits work is huge. It's night and day. You've literally gone up thousands of times in the amount of energy you're putting out. So you can't just teach that kind of thing right off the bat without it really just causing a lot of people to overload. So you teach them how to handle much more stronger exercises by getting the basics down of, okay, since you're going to build up a lot quicker and a lot faster come the second year, this is what you have to be able to do. Make this good feeling and cool come out of you, even though you're putting all this extra energy through you. A lot of times that you know as well as I do, you have to recalibrate your whole cool thing again. Each year, or about every 6 months, when we introduce them to a new energy exercise that will up the ante where it's a lot more powerful, most students realize that they have to go back to the drawing board and actually lower their temperature lower than the 88 to 92 and consistently be checking it, because it will fluctuate so much. That's the amazing thing about this electricity. It can fluctuate by an amazing amount of temperature degrees, and that's why we get the students to buy these laser temperature guns, so that they can regularly check their temperatures to make sure they're in the safe zones for each energy exercise that they do. Because we do that, it seems like the results are so much better from the individuals that are going through. And that's something you've noticed right off, didn't you?
Using the laser gun keeps me in that range, and I'm able to monitor myself. I'm also noticing that when I get heated up, I'm also losing that good feeling. So it is that tri-concept way, or maybe I'm focusing too much on the form. And then I get it back into balance again. I'm so used to pausing and recalibrating. It's just all part and parcel to the nerve fiber building that I do every day.
And that's why we call it a mistake-driven method, because you do realize that sometimes you're going to be thinking about the form too much, or maybe too much on the coolness, that it doesn't feel as good or it's not as formy. Each part, that's the hardest thing about learning the tri-concept and why it takes about a year to get it down really well, is it is hard to do one-third, one-third, one-third. And it's so much easier just to focus on just the form, or, well, I'll just focus on the cool. And these will not get you to them higher levels. If you really want to be able to go to these abilities where you can do things that just seem impossible, then it takes a certain amount of precision in order to be able to do that. Now, the people that come in with a no pain, no gain type of attitude, and I certainly, when I first got into this, I came in with that attitude, get hurt a lot. I certainly overloaded my body constantly went through this roller coaster ride until I learned that this is not how you play with electricity. Electricity will burn you. It will hurt you in ways you can't even think about. And your whole system inside you, your nervous system, is electrical. So it moves around these biophotons very efficiently, very well. And if you do these flow patterns that we teach you in the school, then you start learning to build them up in really physical ways. By the end of the third year, most of our students can literally put out a form enough of chi that they can actually contract a person's muscles out. Like if you took a energy down a person's arm or their leg, you could feel where, or you could literally physically see where it would be popping up the muscles in different places on the leg or the arm as you would bring that energy through. Now, that's a lot of energy. And that's strictly just even after the third year. In the fourth year, the energy goes way up as you take the instructor courses. It's a huge difference. The first year, if you're going just through the first year of school, you're not going to normally the extreme ability level. Although some people would say, well, it's kind of extreme that you can fill through a closed container, or you can move a drinking straw around in a closed container, or you can feel collars blindfolded, or a host of the other things, like bend a spoon or something like that. Some people think those are like extreme abilities, but them are not the type of extreme abilities that we're talking about that you can go to if you go through the entire school. This literally will lead to a radical change in people since they can physically feel this projection of chi in a real way. And you can feel yourself build it up all along the way. So it doesn't plateau in a lot of the metaphysical type systems out there that they want you to visualize all these different things. And it's really hard to sometimes be able to do that if you're not a person who can visualize. So you may or may not be able to work that way. The cool thing about our school, you don't have to be able to visualize at all. You just have to do these small things that we're showing you to do and do them consistently. The other thing is it doesn't take a long time. If you're willing to put in about 30 minutes a day, you can get really good at this where people will be able to physically feel your chi. And it won't take very much time in order to do that. A lot of people would say even in the first few months, they learned that ability to project chi strong enough for other people to feel that. That's pretty good. Both you and I went through systems that it took a lot longer than things like that before anybody felt anything, huh?
Exactly, and I think the best part about it is that it's circular type of energy. It's circular type of energy, and therefore, nobody's affecting directly my nerve fiber system. You've taught me, Sifu Jones, that along the way, just in year one alone, you learn that circular way, and before you know it, it's a whole matter of learning not to deal directly with that energy coming in you, but to make it in a circular way, good feeling and cool. So you're helping yourself and you're helping another at the same time. It's really excellent just in year one alone.
It really is, and it's worth learning just the things that you would learn in just that first year. But it really gets you thinking about doing the energy right that first year. When you start learning all these different topics about how you deal with other people and it's on this pheromone level, simply by cooling your energy down, you can cool down your pheromones so that they're always on this attracting side. There's so many things that you can stack the deck in your favor when you know that this is the way your energy works and that you're putting out the right kind of energy. It really can help a person in every walk of life simply by learning the first year of our school. Again, you don't really get into the power of the energy exercises until that second, third, and fourth year. And it really is because you have to learn the good feeling and cool thing in order to be able to almost survive the other parts of it without just going through a really rough roller coaster ride. It's important that you learn that cool process and that you make energy feel good. And we do everything we can so that that student is able to be able to do that in our school. That's the main thing I wanted to go over is this seminar on that first year of training and what it's about. It's taking a person who's usually on the yang side and bringing them over to the yin side so that they can go up to the mountaintop. So, thank you.